battery market is looking to formulate here in Australia at the moment. We see our project as being one of those catalysing projects to initiate that. The beauty of the native redox-flow battery is you only need vanadium with the plenty over here.
This patch of dirt in northwest Queensland, approximately 655 kilometres west of Townsville and 255 kilometres east of Mount Isa, could hold a key piece of Queensland's renewable energy puzzle.
We've got a critical minerals project up in Julia Creek that we're developing, and we've been through the exploration phase. We know we've got quite a substantial resource on a global basis, and we're having quite some success with that.
The Northwest Minerals Province, which includes Mount Isa and Cloncurry, is one of the world's richest mineral-producing regions. In nearby Townsville, a vanadium processing plant will ensure locally mined vanadium can be used in battery technology. While most of the world's mined vanadium is currently being used to make steel, it's the use of vanadium in creating batteries that has put this element front and centre in conversations about renewable energy.
We're developing the Dibella Critical Minerals Mine in northwest Queensland and an integrated vanadium electrolyte manufacturing facility in Townsville. We're going to use the vanadium for batteries, and these are large-scale stationary batteries that will be used to support the electricity network. Vanadium has some special attributes that means that the batteries that it's used in don't degrade over the 25-year life of the battery, so it makes them a very sustainable and long-duration product.
The thing about these critical minerals that the world needs for the energy transition, for batteries, renewable technology, is that the demand is new, and what's happened is that those supply chains we need don't exist.
With wind and solar power generation on the rise, attention is now on battery storage solutions to ensure we can keep the lights on even when it's dark and not windy, or for times where demand exceeds output. Right now, the most common solution is lithium-ion batteries, the same type of battery used in electric vehicles and home battery solutions.
The battery systems that we use are lithium-ion phosphate batteries, so it's really inside the device itself, it's just a mechanical movement of lithium ions from one side of the battery to the other. It is different to, for example, a lead acid battery, where you actually have a chemical change inside the battery. So there's a number of types of lithium ion batteries, LFP, lithium ferrophosphate, NMC, NCA, there's a few other types. They all still do the same thing. If you're moving your lithium ion across, you can put it into different things. The chemistry we use is LFP.
Founded in 2005, Brisbane-based Redflow is manufacturing one of the world's smallest and most scalable zinc bromide flow batteries.
We are a long duration battery that goes from 3 to approximately 12 hours. We're fully recyclable and we also have no risk of thermal runaway. Redflow's flow battery can be used in commercial and industrial situations. We're also deployed in telecommunication mobile towers, and we're also doing and have done our first large deployment of a 2 megawatt hour system in California.
A flow battery is a hybrid between a battery and a fuel cell. It consists of two tanks of an electrolyte liquid, one positive and one negative. Between the cells is a cell stack where the positive and negative solutions are pumped, but kept separated by a membrane. Inside the cell stack, the ions in the negatively charged solution give up an electron, a process called oxidation. High purity alumina is another battery technology being explored in Queensland. Lava Blue researchers are using real-time information to refine processing of the mineral.
Lava Blue is a startup company with a clay resource up at Lava Plains, and they approached QUT to see if we could develop the science and the processes around extracting aluminium from that clay resource to make high purity alumina. High purity alumina is alumina that has a purity level of 99.99% or better. And the reason we are able to achieve those purity levels is because we have real-time monitoring with a number of sensors that monitors the chemistry, which informs our operators when to start and stop a process. We're now taking it to the next level where we're going to take that product and make separate ceramic-coated separators for batteries. And we're going to do that with the National Battery Testing Centre. We're going to make the coatings, we're going to put them into batteries and do the performance and safety testing.
A key piece of Queensland's battery puzzle was the establishment of the National Battery Testing Centre in Banyo on Brisbane's north side. The centre has the technology to test multiple types and sizes of battery systems in real-world conditions.
It's really important that we diversify the different energy storage solutions that we have, because they some technologies are better suited to different use cases. So if we can develop and test and get the standards up to scratch that we need to deploy different types of energy storage solutions here, we'll be able to get better solutions out to the market.
Queensland is in a prime position to become a world leader in battery technology, with access to the minerals required, local businesses developing innovative solutions, and facilities to test that technology. And that means more jobs for Queenslanders.
Queensland has a rich endowment of these minerals. So we have almost a duty on one hand to help the world meet its needs for the transitions. On the other hand, a great opportunity for Queensland to move, transition away from some of the old industries we have and create new industries.